I'm Hayden, and this is my husband, Aaron, and we're on a mission to visit every country in the world. Along the way, we want to share with you efforts made to create a more sustainable planet for us all to live on. Today, we're bringing you to the Dutch Caribbean island of Curacao, which is leading conservation efforts through coral restoration projects, reef cleanups, sea turtle preservation, and plastic recycling programs.
Today we're doing our first cleanup dive with the dive bus here in Curacao, and we've gotten our briefing. They gave us cutter tools and gloves and bags and everything, and we're gonna head to one of the house reefs here, and he said there's a lot of like fishing line and stuff that we can clean up. And it's good to just work with Project Aware, which is really all about cleaning up the reefs around the world. So we're excited to be a part of it.
Dive shops have joined Project Aware's Adopt a Dive Site initiative by conducting monthly dive against debris cleanup dives. By removing discarded fishing line and trash, it's helping to keep the reefs healthy and thriving. An estimated 30% of the decline in some fish populations is a result of discarded fishing equipment, while more than 70% of marine animal entanglements involve abandoned plastic fishing nets. The health of the reefs have been diminishing over the years, and both elkhorn and staghorn corals are listed as critically endangered due to massive bleaching events, disease, and pollution. Corals are essential in helping maintain the ocean's biodiversity. Coral restoration programs on the ABC Islands are helping to rebuild the reefs by growing and outplanting these types of corals back on the seabed floor in the hopes that the reefs can be saved. Sea turtles play an important role in ocean ecosystems, but some of the largest breeding populations the world has ever known have nearly vanished. Today, loss of coral reef habitats, overfishing, illegal hunting, coastal development, plastic pollution, and climate change are still putting serious pressure on sea turtle populations, which remain threatened with extinction not only in the Caribbean, but across the globe. It has been estimated that the current species extinction rate is between 1,000 and 10,000 times higher than it would be naturally. The three types of turtles that regularly nest on Curacao are green, loggerhead, and the hawksbill. Green and loggerhead sea turtles are classified as endangered, meaning that these species have lost at least 50% of their populations over the last three generations. Hawksbill sea turtles are classified as critically endangered, and their populations have declined by 90%. Significant changes are needed so the reefs don't end up barren of life. Sea Turtle Conservation Curacao and Green Phenix are two amazing initiatives that are attempting to save Curacao's sea turtle populations.
I'm the founder of Sea Turtle Conservation Curacao. This is an organization that protects sea turtles and their habitats through research, conservation, and education. And right now we're standing in our education center, which we have in the Sambu Mall. And basically it shows a little bit about the life cycle of sea turtles, the threats of sea turtles. And we do data collection, we do information sessions here. All of that is basically to do our part to preserve sea turtle conservation for future generations. When they're bigger, obviously, like fishes and birds, we'll not attack them and we'll not see them as prey. But when they're still very small, they're basically making a really good meal for a little fish or a bird. And then you have natural threats, but we also have human-made threats like plastic pollution or habitat degradation or bycatch. So when you eat a lot of fish come to the commercial take, and then that doesn't mean to also catch leatherback turtles, but it does. And then when leatherback populations drop down, basically what we get will be jellyfish bloom, because leatherbacks really like to eat jellyfish. And then when you have jellyfish blooms, they eat like all the fish larvae, and you get like less take. So the threats that we pose on sea turtles by human action basically not only threatening their existence, but basically they can cause a collapse of our whole ecosystem. We have a database, and a lot of projects around the world have that. And what our wish would be is to connect them all, because then we would be able to get migratory information if everybody is able to take pictures of where they're going without having to use satellites. And it's a non-invasive technique, so when you have tourists here that take pictures and they upload them on our, or send them to us, they will automatically help us gather information about the migration routes. And one of the biggest threats that we are seeing around is plastic pollution.
And that's where Green Phenix comes into place, a company that Sabine also founded. It's an innovative program that takes plastic pollution and waste and 3D prints brand new recycled and usable products, which creates a circular economy.
And here we process HDPE and PP plastic, so every bottle has a little number on it, which basically states what type of plastic it is. So all the clear bottles have a number 1, which is PET. We take the labels off, take the bottle caps and the rings off, wash it, it goes into a shredder and it becomes basically flakes. The plastic comes in, and when we have enough of a certain color, basically it goes in through the shredder. We put the bottle in and the flakes come out. This is a raw resource that we can use to produce new things. This is a building block. This is one of the products from the precious plastic community, which is shared open source. So basically it's meant to enable local communities to use the problem of plastic for good. So we are making building materials that people can use to make separation walls. And the good thing about this is that it's an innovative new building technology, because it's like a Lego block. You can reuse it, you don't need any masonry, plastering, nothing, no paint, because you can already produce it in the nice colors that you want to have it. The little flakes of plastic in here, mm-hmm. It's a screw. Here's our heating elements. So the heating elements warm this screw, pushes the material forward, and it comes out as a toothpaste. So you push it in a mold, let it cool down, and that's what you get, a new product. What happens with beach cleanups, usually they go to the landfill, bringing the problem from one place just to another. And that's a big, big, big problem. And until the end of 2019, Sea Turtle Conservation Curaçao cleaned 215,000 gallons of plastic from the ocean, from one place to another.
They also use recycled plastics in 3D printing.
When, like, architects build a little maquette, they use this technology, but they use virgin plastic. So this is new plastic made out of crude oil. That doesn't really make sense if you use new plastic, or you could also use recycled plastic. So the filament can be recycled. Why not do it with the plastic we have on the island? On our island, environmental issues is not only the only thing that's, you know, an issue. We have a lot of poverty, especially now in the COVID, because a lot of people lost their jobs. But if you have an economy that's completely dependent on tourism, it doesn't work. You need to have a diversified economy, which means that you have to have people able to work with technology as well. And then when we can make our own products, it's going to be easier, because right now we have to import everything. If you want to have a chair, it has to be made somewhere else. We don't have wood as a resource. We don't have, you know, plastic. We don't have oil. Unless we use the waste material, which basically is not a waste material because it's a valuable material. You only have to have enough, and which is quite a lot, from one single type of plastic that you can make into the resource and make new things out of it. We can do a lot in regards to creating the circular economy, because we can do it, and we did it from basically with nothing to start with. So then people that have means can definitely do much better. And that's what we're hoping that will happen.